What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Wolfrock coming to you guys with a special reaction video to a request. So I've had several of you requesters, subscribers that have actually asked me to do this particular person. Again, another person that I've not heard of, but we're going to get to that in a minute. A couple things I want to share with you guys today. So one of my wonderful local subscribers actually contacted me, and I went to breakfast with that subscriber and actually a couple of their friends. It was really cool. We had a great time. We talked about a lot of music. Some of them were also metal music, so we talked about a lot of the genres and stuff like that. So it's really, really, really cool to express music. I normally don't do that just because I don't know them real well, but I've known the subscriber for a while, and we've talked back and forth, and so it was kind of cool. You know, to be on the safe side, we always do a public place anyway, but it was just really cool. We talked a lot about Angelina Jordan, and we talked about her quality of her vocals and where we think that she would be like in 10 years and the style of music. We both have come to an agreement that she basically has a wide range of whatever she wants to do, from either she wants to go down to the pop direction, which I hope she doesn't, and that she doesn't stick to being a diva and kind of stays grounded in her music. And only that, but also her vocals. We really believe that she's going to be more of a jazz-ish, bluish jazz, kind of that grassroots type of a sound. That's what we're thinking, but again, we're just going to enjoy it. So we actually spent some time talking about her a lot just because of different, and we shared different videos, and we talked about her background, her family, stuff like that, different lyrics that we discussed, especially specifically on Shield. And it was just an interesting conversation. We spent about 3 hours of just talking about music. Love music, so it was kind of nice and refreshing to get people talking about the same thing. And then we talked about, of course, my other channel, Ollie the Rock, and we talked about Nightwish and upcoming concerts, Epica, just different bands that we are very intrigued with. Very cool, very awesome. And then they also gave me a gift, which I'm sitting on, which you can't see it, but it's a wolf blanket. Really cool. I thought that was really sweet. They didn't have to do that just because I appreciate it a lot. It means a lot to me that they spend the time to talk about music more than anything else. So it was cool. It was a very fun morning and breakfast. Anyway, we're going to get into this, but I need to get my headphones on because, you know, got to plug in. But before we do, let me get, so the artist that we're going to look at, somebody that I've not heard of, Aurora, and the song is called Running with the Wolves, and this was by a subscriber, so I'm not sure a lot about this person, so we're going to look at some biography just really, really quick. I want to know who she is, because again, I don't know her. It looks like she's a child or kid or teenager. I don't know. Let me look at here. So she was born in 1996. It looks like June 15, 1996. Let's see what style. Let's see. She is from Norwegian, singer, songwriter, and record producer. Wow. Well, that's interesting. I'm just looking at some of the things. Really nothing. Looks like she began creating melodies at the age of 6 years old and began writing lyrics at 9. Jesus, that sounds like somebody we know. Okay, there's definitely not a lot of information except for the song that she released her debut extended play, Running with the Wolves, in 2015 with Decade Records. So I'm interested to see what the song's about. If I decide to do more of her, and if you guys want me to do more of her, let me know as well, and I will we'll dig a little bit more. I just wanted to get a kind of an idea of who she is, just birth and that she's from Norway. Got another great place of great music that I'm starting to notice. So let me go back to the song. Okay, let me get my headphones on because I'm gonna be able to hear. You know what I mean? All right, this is going to be fun. I love new artists. Okay, let's do this. 3, 2, 1, go! Obviously, it's in a visual, official video, so it's not live.
My ears can hear, and my mouth can speak. My spirit talks, I know my soul believes. But we're running out of time. All the echoes in my mind cry.
Okay, that's interesting. I mean, the sound is definitely good. I mean, I'm not going to chew that out. I love the sound. It's got a very popish, rockish type sound. A couple things that it isn't an official video. Official videos are awesome, but they're not as good as live productions just because you get the quality of the sound and the vocals of that particular person. I'll give you an example. Angelina Jordan, when her sound is definitely clear and crystal. You can hear the vocals really clear. I really love that. Dimash is another person, really clear. Leonard, he's a Canadian singer. His live performance is awesome. I really love his vocal. They're just really crystal clear. Flor Jansen, very clear. Marco, also great crystal clear. I love the vocals when it's live. Not saying that she's not a good person. I have not seen any of her other videos, so I don't know what her vocals sound like. I really am. I get attracted to the vocal sound of. You guys know this, and I'm going to say this again so that we're on the same page. Music affects your soul. It affects you as an individual. It affects you, your surroundings. It builds you up. It pumps you up. It gets you excited. It gets you motivated. A great example of a song of the history that is one of those songs that when you hear it, you're like, you're motivated, at least to me anyway. The movie from the song from the movie Rocky. You guys remember the Rocky song, right? We call it the Rocky song for a reason. And when that song gets played, a lot of places that I've heard it, you get like motivated, you know? It's just something about that song. Now, why do you think that happens? It's because it pulls you, it touches your inside soul, that your spirit inside, and you're drawn to it. That's what gets you your who you are as a person. It affects your emotions. Music does that. In this particular performance, it didn't draw me to it. I think she's awesome. She's got great good vocals. I don't think I'm like in love with her yet, but I haven't heard any much. It's the reason why I didn't do any more really dig into it. Well, I would listen to her again. Sure. I'll do a couple more if you guys are interested in me looking at her history as well. Very cool vocals in the essence of this song. Live? I don't know. We'll see. I'm not judging her at all. And I just, it's not one of those things that I'm drawn to. Now, Angelina Jordan, very attracted to as far as her vocals. Oh, so rich, so pure, so awesome. This one? Not sure. I don't have a good feel yet. Maybe a couple more and I'll get a chance to see. But the fact that she was young and she's a songwriter and composer and a producer, that is amazing. I can't do that. Just saying, I can't do that. That is amazing. And that's not that she trained to do that. She's talented. She actually has that in her to do that. That's a gift. Just throwing that out there. I know, kind of a weird guy, but that's just me. Hey, somebody asked me a weird question on my last post. It says, what do you call your subscribers? Subscribers? I don't sound like you guys are wolf packs, you know what I mean? I do enjoy the fact that Angelina Jordan has decided to go with, I think I heard somebody say angel, so that her fan base are angels. I think that's cool. I think that's great. I'm glad that she picked that. Really, it should have come from her, not from her fans. Just like I said with like Dimash, you know, calling deers on one of the deers. And I do appreciate that those individuals would respect the artist and enough to kind of go with the flow of whatever they want. So anyway, thank you so much. You guys are the best. I really appreciate all these requests and all these videos that you guys have sent me. I will get to them, I promise you. On Sundays, I only do one video on both channels. Sundays, I take the time for myself, and I kind of go through the process of answering a lot of the comments and things of that nature, because as you guys know, when you have subscribers, you want to spend time with them and comment with them, because you guys are important to me, and I do appreciate the quality and the time that you guys take, and I want to give that back to you guys, so I try to comment as much as I can. So Sundays, I kind of give that for that reason, so one video. And if I get to a point where I'm like, hey, I can do one more, then I do one more, but most of the time, it's just one and one. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm sorry I'm a little winded. I just wanted to share some information with you guys. And somebody also has requested that I do a bio of my own life. And I think that would be cool, but I don't think it's about me. It's about the music. But if you guys want me to share my kind of my life history experience of music, I would be more than glad to do one. I actually have somewhat something put together for somebody else that wanted something. So if you guys want me to, I will more than glad to give you guys a little bit of a history of my background. I thought I've done that already, but hey, whatever. I don't mind doing it again. Anyway, make sure you leave a comment on the bottom. And as always, I do appreciate you guys. You guys are the best. And we'll give you guys, hopefully you guys have a good Sunday. In some parts of the country, I think it's Monday already, but whatever day it is that you're on, have a great day. And as always, stay classic, because that's what we do on this channel. Love you guys. You guys are the best. We'll catch you next time.